Alright, g'day there. I'm Richard Musgrave-Evans and welcome back. Today, I'm back down the coast, my Ponga Beach, South Australia. Beautiful golden paddocks, land of blue and gold. You've got the beautiful deep blues in there and the turquoises of the ocean. The little township, my Ponga Beach itself. Fantastic subject. Now, today I'm going to be working again with a combination of palette knives and brushes. Bucket loads of oil paint. White prime board, and I'm just about to get into it. Now, you'll notice I've already put the darks in. That was just a quick way of warming up and also just getting a feel of the composition so I know exactly what I want to do next. Okay, so next I'll go for the biggest differences, and I think what I'll do is, I reckon I'll put that water in, okay? So, let's have a look. It's a nice colour today, so I'll go for some cobalt blue and white, a little bit of magenta. Let's see how that goes first. Maybe just a tad more magenta with that mix. Let's get that in with the palette knife first. I'll get the brushes out later or soon, but I just want to block it in a little with this knife, my favourite palette knife. Right, I might just go a little bit more magenta with that blue. There's a bit of seaweed in the foreground area. There's a bit of seaweed in the foreground areas here, which is just a little bit darker, so just going to make it a tad darker here. Don't want to get the paint too thick in the ocean. Okay, there we go, got that. Now I can see some beautiful turquoise colours just in the foreground. What have we got? Just there, there's some. Okay. So, viridian green and white. Slightly smaller brushes to get a little bit more control. It's only a small area I'm working with. Okay, now the deeper part of it, got a slight blue-green twang, so I'll put some of that in. But as it gets closer to the shore, it's more of a yellow ochre and green combo. A bit more of an olive green, but it's still definitely got a turquoise ring about it. Hard to see the subject today, the board's in the way. Now as it gets in closer, it's going more towards a shallow sand colour, which has got, looks like a bit of a burnt sienna yellow ochre combo with white. I'm pretty close to the edge of the road here again today, and I can hear a car just coming up behind me now. So I'll just stick some of that in the bay there, a bit more yellow ochre I reckon. Go. There's a bit of weed there, so with a brush, magentas and blues, a bit more magentas. Just going to paint a bit of that weed in. There's some rocky outcrops here. Into mixing those turquoises. Now, what I'll do is I'll get a brush and just blend all that a bit to soften it all. Might start just there. Just get those waters mixed in. You see what I'm doing? Let's just blend it all together. It's made it a little bit dirty because I'll just get this. Because some of the magentas just here, and some of the earthier colours mixed together then. It's just gone a tad dirty there, but that won't matter. I'll fix that up in a minute. All right, next biggest difference I reckon will be get the sky in. There's a fair bit of high level clouds, so what I'll do is I'll mix up kind of hazy sky today in the distance. You can see a bit of high level cloud up there. Alright, hang on. Now I'll just get a bit of that. Just going to mix up a really pale, light kind of grey colour here and mix it with that a little to make it more of a neutral tone. That's kind of like a warm yellow grey. It's not what I want quite. It's a bit more burnt sienna and white. Just make it up as you go. Not too far off. Let's put that in first. Not quite touching the blue yet. If I touch that blue, I might mess it up. I've got a nice straight line there at the moment on the horizon, so I'll get stuck into that soon, but first I just won't quite touch as I'm blocking it in. Get it like so. Yep, now, there's a little bit of a green going on in the sky there, so just a little bit of blue. Yellow ochre and white, a bit more yellow ochre. What do we have there? What do we have? A bit more blue, mix it up. A bit of green there. Just a bit more of that sky colour up here, like there's a bit of cloud like I said. Keep going with that. A bit cleaner blue and white as I get higher. Going through that white, as always. Get that off. Okay, she's all just going with a knife at the moment, a bit more blue. Might get a brush on it soon, but I'll just get it in there first. A little bit darker and cleaner as I've gone up. Okay, move all that there, go for some blue, magenta, a little bit more of that red-blue colour as it gets high. Let's have a look what you can see. It's hard to see what's going on there, but yeah, it gets a bit more of a red-blue as it goes up. Going to blend those colours a bit. Not quite touching the horizon yet, just staying fairly close, but just off it for now. I'll come back into that soon. For now, I'm just blending all those colours because it is a high level cloud day. There's a lot of softness. Just get the random brush strokes, get it all blocked in. Let's get random marks going. Right, there's a little bit of a haze on the horizon, so with this same brush I might just get a little bit of magenta with the blue that's already on the brush. what is that? Just right on the horizon, there's a bit of a coastal haze, so there's a little bit more of a purpley grey on the horizon. Almost touching. Take my time through this area. Now, just lightly pull the two together so they haze off into each other. That beautiful distant coastal haze. Straight lines through there, straight horizon. We'll just stand back and have a look. Alright, biggest difference is, what are we going to do here? Let's grab a bit of paper towel first, excuse me. I'll just pop the paper towel there so it's out of the way. Right, now, I've got all the shadows. There's obviously, those are trees. They're a much lighter tone than I've got. I've put the shadow tone in, but I haven't got the other colour in yet, so I'll mix them up. What have we got? Yellow ochre. Burnt sienna, maybe with a bit of that green from earlier. What colour have we got today? More burnt sienna, a bit more of that green. Let's just lightly touch and see. It's not too bad. So I leave a lot of the undertone coming through. Just drag the brush. What have we got? Going up this way. And there's a bit more yellow ochre in it. Burnt sienna. Green. A bit more of the yellow ochre or less of the green. So that's more of a khaki type colour with a bit burnt sienna there. Too bad. A couple of upward flecks there. A few she oaks. Hard to see what I'm doing today. I'm kind of in the way of myself. The painting's in the way of the view. So I'm dancing around a little. Yeah, that's not too much of a problem, I guess. Just knocking it back a bit as it recedes with a bit of blues and purples, magentas and whatever. Township itself here, stick some of those trees in lightly. See, just here, it's a bit more of a red in that. A bit on the horizon there, some coming down the hill, a bit here and there. Alright, so there's a lot. Got most of those sort of trees all blocked in. Now, I might just move that to one side. Place that in the bin. Okay, let's get that, let's put those paddocks in. Today, it'll be yellow ochre and burnt sienna to start with. And white, of course, always white. Quite rich in some areas. Let's get it in first. What are we doing here? Get all this paddock in. Look at that. Look at that. It's got these flies buzzing around. It seems to be part of the act. I colouring in at the moment, obviously, look by the looks of it. Getting rid of that whiteboard. All the colours I work on, all the different old painting on the raw linen is a toned down version. It's all right, but painting on white, there's something good about white. I mean, that's probably why a lot of people paint on white. It lets the undertone show through, particularly in the shadows, and the reds and that can really glow with the white showing through them. Basically, I don't think it really matters. All you got to do is do what works at the time. It's all good. That paddock there is a bit more keyed off. Not that keyed off, a bit more brown than sienna. White. Let's have a look where we got. Smearing and pulling, dragging with the knife. It's always fun. Pulling through, like softening by dragging the knife through. Yeah, it's all starting to come together. A bit more yellow ochre over here, white. Okay, now. Paddock out there. A little bit, it's a little bit too green. Some of the greens are mixing in, so I'm just going with a bit of a warmer colour on top. That off. Right, put that one down for a minute. Here comes the car. Burnt sienna. A bit more burnt sienna on the cliff here. People always slow down when they see you painting. I guess you just don't see it every day, so it's something a bit different. A bit intriguing. Let's paint that headland. Now, just going to mix a bit of an orange here with my yellow and red, like I've done on some of the previous videos. Half mix that with that. The headland's just a little brighter. It's got some really pale oranges on the cliff on the headland there. Really bright, stinging sort of colours. You don't want to waste them, so stick them in. Stand back and have a look. Going to drag back and take a bit of paint off there. Another car coming. White. There is a little bit of dust coming from those cars, but it's not too bad. So I'm going yellow ochre and burnt sienna and white mainly there. I'm going to paint a bit of that beach, which is over here. Maybe make it a tight, whoops, make it clean for a start. We want clean colours. We're going white and orange, yellow there to really pop it. Touch of burnt sienna, keep it down a bit. that beach in there. Dragging with the knife now. Before we go any further, we'll just get another brush out. I'm going to touch up some of that water in the little bay here. I'll just rub a little bit of paint off there so it doesn't get in the way while I'm doing it. So the paint's a bit thinner. I just want to make that bay absolutely beautiful. So get those lovely greens and whatever. Yellow ochres. Viridian green yellow ochre. Make that beautiful and soft in there, like a real beautiful place to, just a beautiful place to want to hang out. You see the water and you just go, oh, geez, I want to be down there. That's what you try and paint in your picture. You try and paint it so it entices people to want to be there. So if you find those areas beautiful, really bring them up. Allow everyone to see what you can see in the landscape. Bring out the beauty. Feels good. Soften that. Okay, just drop these brushes here. Clean that a bit. Now with a clean brush, it's got a bit of blue on it, that'll be fine. Just want to lightly soften the edge of this cliff so it sort of falls away into the, just lightly drag through it. Just takes the edge off it. Gotta be careful though. Have a look. Slightly soften there too. Just feeling everything as I go, always working around the picture. Move the paint around in there a bit, make some random strokes. A few upward ones for grass. Find the right spot to do it. It's getting my peak early here now, I can hear another car coming. A while ago I had it all to myself. Alright, time to put some of those little buildings in. I can see them lying. Now with my finger I'll just rub some of those shadows in there because I want those shadows to be there. That's where I'm going to be sticking the buildings. Maybe take a bit of paint off here and there to show shadow forms of the buildings. More flies. Alright. Some white with a bit of cat orange. Where are those buildings? Rightio. Just with a knife on edge, I'll just pull a few buildings in here and there. Oop, hang on. Buildings are always great, they give the illusion of detail in a very loose impressionistic style of painting. The little buildings give you The little buildings give you a fantastic illusion of detail. Now with the knife, you can just take the bottom off that by scraping some paint off. Get back to the shadow colour, which is not coming through that well, so I might make my own again. Just want to clean up some shadowy areas. So the buildings have got something to sit against. That's a bit too dark. It's not quite in keeping with the rest of the shadows in that area, so just lighten that a bit. Right. Some of that, a bit of burnt sienna. Magentas and blues. I'm just trying to get a kind of a browny grey. Magentas and blues and whatever. Just want to paint, lightly drag in some of the rockery down there on the beach. I'll stand back and have a look. Right. Now there's not a lot of wind down there on the water, but there is a bit of wind. And when the wind blows, it sort of stands the waves up a little bit so you can see into the water, and it makes the water a nice deep colour. But then you get that slack water where there's no wind, you get those really pale blues. Now there's a bit of that going on, and that always looks great, so I'm mixing up a bit of pale blue, which I could probably use some of that sky blue from earlier. Even a bit of that yellow ochre, because it's reflecting the sky, you've got to realise. Just rub it in. It gives you the feeling. Gives you the feeling of the slack water. Right. Let's stand back and have a look. A fair bit of kind of slack water right on the edge of this headland here, and that's good because it kind of, what that's doing is it's allowing me to put a light tone there to really jut that headland out. Before we go any further, always working around the canvas or the board or whatever you're painting on, never finishing anything before anything else. What the? I've run out of white. I'm going to get some more white on the board. Just trying to throw in a bit of that high level cloud, but that's not quite good enough because the white's starting to go. With a brush, just lightly rub through that. It is high level cloud, so it shouldn't have too hard an edge, because high level cloud is, or all cloud mainly, but particularly high level cloud, very soft. Okay, now you can see, let's get up, soften that water a bit just there, pull through. All right, I'll get some more white out because it's just one of those colours you need, obviously. So clean the knife so I don't put all crap in there. All right, so as you can see, I buy them in these massive tins. This is actually a litre. Fantastic for laying the paint on. It's a cheaper way to buy it. Okay, what do we got here? Clean the knife. Slightly pull through. Down, clarifying some of the details there. Right. Putting those buildings back in, I kind of lost them a bit here and there. Now, put a lot of paint on, now I'll take some off by scraping on the underside. Take some paint off here and there. Now, you've got to realise I'm painting the illusion of buildings. You don't have to paint every single building exactly how it is. You're trying to give a general feel of the building. We've got a red roof here to make it pop. A couple of red roofs here and there. Yep. Right. A little white. Got the knife on edge. Bit of a road coming down that hill, it looks kind of cool, so I'll go like this and put it through. Just take some paint up there. Make the road a little bit narrower. So that leads you into the township. Let's have a look. Let's get that edge. That's one of the keynotes there, if not the main one. That little headland. Just knock up a bit of a foliage colour again over here. Put it up on the headland here. There's a few trees up on the hill. A few kicking around here and there. Coming down the side of the paddock there. Yeah, right. Better mark, I need to get some pure white with a bit of yellow, real bright. What are we gonna do here? Make a better roof, more of a statement. Now I just take the bottom off again. Scrape some of the paint off here and there. Pull through there, make that sand really soft. Some of the white on the edges, don't need too much white on the edges. Draws your eye away from the subject. Alright, now make sure I'm out of the way. It's clarifying the edge of that road a bit. Maybe pull some of that grass colour up into that. Yeah. Right. How much fun, eh? How much fun is this? Okay, now. A little bit more of those darks that I seem to have lost on the hill over there. Using a cobalt blue and magenta just to make a kind of purple pale blue shadow colour. Put one there. Building a few of the shadows. There's a bit of a bridge running along here, so I'll put that on edge. Keep on building that township up now, like I said before, get the edge of the knife and go under it to clean the bottom side of the roof up. Makes it look so much more refined, way more like a building if you can get the underside nice and clean. Getting there. There's some real nice cliffy that cliff has on the end has a real nice highlight effect like so on it. Except doesn't have that there, get rid of that. Just sting the accent, the headland. Got a really big brush, I'm just going to do a little bit of softening here and there by actually rubbing through paint that's already there with a clean knife. Got to pick your spots, but what I'm trying to do is just soften the picture a little bit here and there. Rubbing it clean each time. What I might also do, this grass in the foreground's nice. Might whip up a bit more of a brew. Plenty of white, yellows. Make it really jump out here, like really put the paint on. Stick it on thick. Why not, eh? Random brush marks in the foreground. Give the feeling of grass. Soften a bit. The edge of this knife here is going to pull through. Get some of that red coming back there. I've got red in the shadows there. By taking it back, I can bring the red back, and the red really pops against the green foliage. At the same time, it's softening and abstracting. Getting a bit of draftsmanship going here and there. A little bit of the paddock showing through some of this area. Soften again. Just got little bits coming through where it's not only that, it's also good to kind of open it up so it's not blocking the eye too much. Maybe add a bit here, let the eye through so I can get into the picture. What's going on here is I'm basically, what am I doing? I'll get some more yellow ochre on that. I'm trying to add a bit of variety into the colours of the paddocks. There's some beautiful golden colours and there's greys and there's this and there's that. I'm trying to put that variety into the subject. A bit more chunk in the foreground. Clean this right off, absolutely clean. What do I want to do? I just want to lightly pull through and soften that edge. Like so. Make that really soft to contrast the chunkiness of the hills. Have a look. Another vehicle on the way. Just going to draw a couple of branches in here and there, a bit of detail. Cut the knife on edge. Beautiful day today out here, I tell you what, beautiful weather. Absolutely fantastic. So I'm just putting a few lines and dots. Pull some of that paint down. Here comes the car. They're coming in. They're coming in. Dust and all, eh? Dust and all. Right. What do you do, eh?
It's a terrible place to paint.
Yeah, I know, it's pretty bad, isn't it?
Wow. That is quite a view, isn't it?
Fantastic.
Oh, and that's quite a piece of art. That's beautiful.
Oh, thank
that's
you.
Gonna be awesome. Wow.
I'm actually filming it too.
Oh, sorry.
That's alright, no, you're fine. I just, that's what I do, I paint and also film what I'm doing. Just getting some of those rooftops in.
Beautiful.
I think.
What a view.
It's a great spot.
Yeah, isn't it? It does.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's a good location. I was actually meaning to paint down there, and on the way down the hill, I found this one. I got more to paint here.
Yeah.
Didn't know about this spot. I know that over by those farm buildings over there is a nice spot.
Okay.
Going down looking for that one.
Wow. May I take a picture of your painting?
Yeah, that's fine.
Sure?
Yeah.
And I hope you didn't put the dust on there.
No, it's actually, the wind's all right today, so didn't really come in.
Go up nice and easy.
Yeah, okay.
That's fun.
All right, no worries, thank you.
Bye.
Ta. Beautiful. I see the road just jutting down through here.
The track that they just came up,
that road's just jutting through there. So, I'll put that in. And also, you can see it coming back up through the hill here. There's flies, always there. Here they go. How entertaining is that? People love watching you paint, it's just a good thing. Alright. Just stand back and have a look now. Okay, now with a little brush, what have we got here? That turquoise is such a nice colour. I just want to introduce it into the bay a little further. So, what we got here? A bit of blue around the edges like that, just like some of that blue I was saying before from the slack patches of water. There's a real nice one coming across here. Like so. What I need to do once I've done that is get a brush and soften that mark. One more of those, what do we got? Oops, I'll get that one in a minute. Pull through quickly to give it confidence. Keep refining, always working around, just taking a little bit off that roof. That's one of the key notes. So make that roof really highly finished. If you make some of the rooftops or some of the parts of the picture highly finished, it'll make the rest of the picture look finished. So you just got to pick the right spots, put the work in there. Now I'm just going to clarify a few of the edges of the roofs, get them clean and more like the shape of a roof by taking a bit of paint off here and there. One didn't work, that's better. Keep adding a few more buildings. Break making these trunks up a bit, not just painting the trunk like a straight line, but breaking it patchy, because the light seems to hit with light and shadow. So if you break it all up, it looks, the trunk that is, instead of just doing a line, make it patchy and break it up, it gives it more of the feeling of light hitting tree trunks. Another car coming up the hill, it's flat out today. Clean up that mess. Right, busy location. Such a lovely spot, that's why. Now there's a nice little track out on the headland I might just put in now. Just out here. A little bit of a road, get the knife on edge. All good, all good. Here comes the vehicle. Just constantly adding and refining. Giving the feeling of detail with little marks. When you paint big and broad, those little marks can really make the painting, really start to finish the painting. Because what happens is you've got big broad marks, and as soon as you go little fine, all of a sudden you've got the illusion of detail on top of the broadness, and that gives you a nice kind of abstract realism. And there's a couple more farm buildings up here which are nice, so I'm just going to, there's a little bit of a building up in the trees, up in the thickets there. Stick those ones in. It's just a thing, how much do you want to put in? Like, it's already, we've already got the feeling of the real world. It's just how much work do you want to do? Brush there. All right, well, I reckon that'll about do. I've got the big impression. And I'm pretty happy with it, actually. It's a very broad looking painting, but at the same time it's quite detailed and refined, and it's exactly what I was after. So what I'll do is I'll get the camera off and let you have a look. No worries, thank you. Alright, let's just see what we've got here. There you go. And now we'll have a look. So you can see here, you've got that beautiful little township, Maiponga. Fantastic little bay with the turquoise waters. Sheltered bay. Beautiful sands and a lovely headland. More of the township just here. You can see I've applied the paint very thickly and chunkily, chunkishly, quite abstracted. But if you can get the marks in the right spot, it'll give the illusion of quite a finished piece. See, I got the high level cloud today. Very soft and contrasting. Set it off into the distance. The water's very soft to contrast a thick chunk of the foreground. And that foreground being so chunky and thick, and that being so thin in the distance, really makes the foreground come forward and the distance recede. Alright, Maiponga Beach, South Australia, midday light.